Hello learners, welcome to this session on developing vocabulary. I am Kirti Kapoor, professor of English. So let's begin with our session. The topic is developing vocabulary, which is an important aspect of language learning. What do we mean by vocabulary? Vocabulary is a set of words that one knows in any language, and it is a fundamental tool for communication and acquiring knowledge across the disciplines. Vocabulary usually grows and evolves with age. It is essential for learners to be able to use a language effectively. Therefore, we understand that vocabulary plays an important role in language learning. Now, context matter. We cannot use words just like that without context. If words are learnt as isolated elements, they are quickly forgotten. To improve language skills, expand knowledge of the range of words appropriate to a setting. When I say appropriate to a setting, it means according to the context. Meanings of words are defined by context and they change their meaning accordingly. For example, let's take the word bear. Bear as a noun means it's an animal. But if I want to use the same word as a verb, it means I cannot tolerate something. So therefore, context plays an important role in vocabulary learning. Now, words can be single, they can be parts of words, there can be compound words, there are fixed phrases, then there are idiomatic expressions. Words generally lead to words. We learn like that. Let's take examples of single words. Single words are run, ice, catch, cold. Sometimes without the context also, they are conveying meaning. Some words are parts of the words. From sad, we can say sadness by adding a prefix or a suffix. Then there are compound words like football, moonlight. Then fixed phrases are there, during the day, in the meantime. Then we have idiomatic expressions. It's raining, cats and dogs. So vocabulary is not only words, it is a range of different types of words being used in different contexts. Now, vocabulary in the English language classroom. Now, let's differentiate between active and passive vocabulary. Develop a vocabulary through activities. Understand importance of vocabulary in language learning. Explore the stages of learning vocabulary. Understand various aspects of vocabulary learning. Develop tasks for learning vocabulary. So, in this module, we are going to talk about all these topics. Now, you know a word when you know how it is pronounced and spelled. Okay? How, where, and when it is used. I cannot say I know a word when I don't know how to use it. I must understand its grammatical category, whether it's a noun, verb, or an adjective. Then only I can say I know a word and I must know where to use it. You know a word when you know its denotative meaning. Denotative meaning means core meaning, the literal meaning of the word. Generally we think vocabulary is only word meanings. That is not so. It has connotative meaning also and association. Some meanings are associated meanings, emotional or otherwise, which the word evokes. Then its syntactic behavior, that is the type of meaning it expresses. You know a word when you know the associations it forms, the limitations there are to its use, how frequently it occurs in spoken and written languages. There are some words which we use quite a lot. There are some words which we use rarely. You know a word when you know its root form. For example, home. The affixes that it can have. For happy, we can use the affix un and then we can make it unhappy. Suffixes it can take, for example, homeless. Then synonyms, cheerful, joyful. Joyful is the synonym of cheerful and cheerful is the synonym of joyful. You can add more synonyms to it. There are many synonyms. You can add happy to it. Now, antonym of joyful is sad. Then next is denotation, home, house, resident, dwelling. These are some of the synonyms of the word home. But denotative meaning is home, where a person lives, just like that. That is its denotative meaning. That is what its core meaning is. Then connotation. Home, when we say this is my home, it gives me a cozy feeling. I live here. I am comfortable inside my house. And house is just a building or a structure. Residence connotation is cold or no feeling. This is the residence of so and so. That means I don't have the right to enter this building, dwelling, primitive or basic surroundings. So these are synonyms, but they have different connotative meanings. Now let us look at this poem. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. You must be wondering, why am I reading this poem? Let's read it again. Let's identify words. The words that we use frequently, cloud, and the word that is not used so frequently, whales. So when you are reading a particular text, whether it is a poem or a prose piece or a story or a newspaper article, you come across words which are familiar and which are not so familiar. So frequently used word in this poem is cloud, because every day we talk about clouds. Today it is cloudy, today there are no clouds, etc., etc. And we rarely talk about vales and valleys because we don't live in such surroundings. Now, active and passive vocabulary. Now, after reading this poem, we have been able to identify our active and passive vocabulary. Words that we use frequently are lonely, cloud, hills, crowd, trees, lake, golden, isn't it? And when you come across words that you understand but you don't use them so often, these words are floats, whales, wandered, host, daffodils, fluttering. So you understand the meaning of these words, but you don't use them very often. So this becomes your passive vocabulary. One leads to another. See, we must change our passive vocabulary into active vocabulary if we want to develop our vocabulary. Words we understand when listening and reading, and also use when speaking and writing. They are part of our active vocabulary. And words we recognize but we don't use when communicating. That is, these words are part of our passive vocabulary. With time, when we are able to use words in our passive vocabulary when speaking and writing, then these become a part of our active vocabulary again. So therefore, I think we should make a conscious effort to make words from our passive vocabulary a part of our active vocabulary to develop the range of our words. Now, building vocabulary. Now, let us understand how we can build our vocabulary. It's good for students, it's good for teachers, it's good for all of us. We need to build our vocabulary. Now, word web. There are some activities that can be taken up in the classroom. Word web is one of them. For example, let us take the word weather. And under weather, if we write 42 degrees Celsius, that means it's hot. So, and we give four categories to the students. What accessories do you need? What kind of food and drinks do you have when it is very hot? What kind of clothes do you wear? And what is it? What is the season? So, it is largely summer season. And we use a cap or a hat, we use umbrella to cover our heads. And in summer season, we use cold drinks like lemonade, we eat cucumber, it keeps us cool. We wear very light colored cotton clothes. So therefore, from one word and by giving a few hints, we have developed the entire context. So this is how from a vocabulary can be built from a context. A word web can help us develop our vocabulary. Now, let us talk about trees. The picture itself tells us this is a tree. So, what kind of topics can be taken up on a tree? We can take up the topic of fruits. What kind of fruits do we get from trees? We get mango, we get oranges, there are many more. Or if we want to make it simpler, what types of trees are found around us? Or what are the parts of the tree? So by just giving a context, we can talk about lot many things related to a particular word, that is trees. Now another activity is spot the odd one out. You can give jumbled words to the students which are more or less synonyms, but one is the odd one out, and ask them to find out which is not related to that category. Now I have here given you the words like anecdote, story, tale, myth. Next category is vocation, vacation, job, profession. Next category is solitude, indifference, loneliness, isolation. Then unique, usual, exquisite, special. Next is dreadful, horrible, terrible, deadly, distress, unhappiness, disbelief, misery. So in one particular category, in one particular table, you have to find out the odd one out. Let us see in our next slide which is the odd one out. Okay, here myth is odd one out, vocation is odd one out, because vocation, job and profession talk about, they are synonyms, they talk about the kind of work that we do. Similarly, you can read on your screen about other words. Now word ladder, this is another game that you can play with your students, or you can do it with your friends to develop your vocabulary from cold to warm in 4 steps. Have you observed that warm has been turned into cold by changing one letter in each step, at each step? At each step I have to change the letter in such a way that it creates a new word. It's a meaningful word. By changing A into O, it becomes worm. Then by changing M into D, it becomes word. Then by changing W into C, it becomes cod. And then finally, R has been changed into L and it has become cold. So from warm to cold. You can play such a game with other words. Next is how many words. Can you make with the word grandmother? You can give any word and you can create a number of words out of that. Like from grandmother, gran, an, other, gone, the, her, and grander. There are many more that can be created. Remember, we need to use a word from 7 to 14 times in different contexts to make it a part of our active vocabulary. Otherwise, the words that we learn will remain a part of our passive vocabulary. But we need to consciously use them in different contexts to make them a part of our active vocabulary. Word puzzles. Now, word puzzles are another type of activity that can be taken up in the classroom to help develop words in context, vocabulary in context. It promotes help complete sentences. She will miss the meeting. She has gone dash. Now hints are given here. Some letters of the alphabet are given. So she has gone somewhere and we need to fill it. Maybe it is abroad. He is smart and dash. It begins with the letter C. Maybe he is confident. Let us see. Yes, she has gone abroad. He is smart and confident. You can give a few letters and ask the students to complete the context looking at the sentence. It will help learners use the new word in the context. Let us solve a crossword. Now, solving a crossword also is like reading, comprehending, and then finding the appropriate word. Okay, what color are brinjals? Look how dash the grass is. This is the color of snow. Penguins are white and dash. So I am reading, comprehending, and also then trying to find out the appropriate word. And it is based on colors. I have understood that much. Sunflowers are a bright dash. This color is also the name of a fruit. Many bears are this color. The sky is dash. Look at the dash fire engine. Mix red and white to get dash. Let's look at the answers. Yes. What color are brinjals? They are purple. Look how green the grass is. See, across. You look at the words across. You will find the word green, you will find the word white, purple, black. Penguins are white and black. Similarly, down means from up to down. Sunflowers are a bright yellow. The color is also the name of a fruit, orange. Many bears are of this color, that's brown. The sky is blue. Similarly, you can play with other categories and have crosswords for the learners to learn new words in context. Looking up a dictionary, yes, this is an important task. Dictionary will help you to understand what is the meaning of a word, how it is to be pronounced. Now, dictionary is a noun and the plural noun is dictionaries. Which category does the word belong to, whether it is a noun or a verb or an adjective. So, I have given you the dictionary meaning of the word dictionary, a book or electronic resource listing the words of a language in alphabetic order along with their meaning, information about pronunciation, origin and usage, the equivalent words in a different language. Now, the synonyms of dictionary are lexicon, word books, word list, glossary, thesaurus. So, therefore, you learn lot of new words from a dictionary. And it will create a context for that particular word. So, next is collocation, combining words to create new meanings. Let's look at these words, close, high, big, hard, light, serious. Then on this side, I have salary, disappointment, friend, sleeper, work, endless. These words have their own meaning. Light means something which is very light. But if I combine light with sleeper, it becomes light sleeper. That means this person wakes up at a slightest noise. So it is a different, it's a new meaning. So this is known as collocation. Serious illness, high salary. So like this, we can combine two words and create a new meaning. Techniques that could be used for learning new words. A physical demonstration using mime or gesture. This is a way of learning the meaning of new words. Either we can show the picture or we can mime it, or through gestures we can convey the meaning of the words. A verbal explanation involving a number of contexts, a long journey, a hard day's work. So therefore we can explain. Giving synonyms or antonyms also will help us understand the meaning. Then translation. Maybe here the mother tongue can be used as a resource in the classroom. If the children are not able to understand the meaning, we can use mother tongue as a resource in the classroom. And then move on to L2, visual aid, photograph, picture, etc. Dictionary, word formation by adding suffix or prefix, crossword, etc. So these are some of the techniques that you can bring into your classroom to teach new words, to develop vocabulary. Then learning vocabulary, more strategies. I'm giving you more strategies. Yes, you can enhance your vocabulary by using words in sentences. You see, by learning words in isolation will not help us remember the words or be able to use the words in different contexts. Therefore, it makes sense to use them in sentences of our own, filling words in blanks. Because if we are filling words in blanks, then we are creating a complete context, identifying their correct meaning in context. Dictionary can help us do so. Using these in conversation, we should be able to use the words that we have learned in our conversation, making sentences using these words with the help of a substitution table. Maybe synonyms and antonyms can help us develop the range of our words. You can enhance vocabulary by practicing word sets, replacing these with synonyms in sentences. Yes, you might be able to create a new sentence if you replace it with a synonym, using vocabulary games, using word categories. Now, recording meaning. It is very important that when you learn new words, you must record it. When you write a new word in your vocabulary network, you add extra information to help remember. Therefore, it becomes permanent. Therefore, it becomes part of your active vocabulary. And it will create a context also for you to remember where to use the word, when to use this word. Now, for example, commute. To travel a long way from home to work every day. So, I commute from this place to that place every day. So, commute, maybe it is a difficult word, but when you write its meaning like this, that when I travel a long way from home to my place of work or to my school or to my college every day, you are writing an explanation of that particular word to remember the meaning and be able to use it effectively in future. Flex time. Flex time is a new word. So, it means I can start my work anytime. I don't have to work from 9 to 5:30. I have flex time because I have been given the target. I have to complete some target. I can finish it in 2 hours. I can finish it in 20 hours. But I must finish it within the stipulated time. So, meaning in a sentence. You can frame this particular idea in a sentence to remember it and be able to use it in as part of your active vocabulary, employed. I have given here the antonym, the opposite of it, unemployed. So, this is how I remember the meanings of the words through different contexts, in different ways. Keyring, by showing a picture, by looking at a picture. Okay, this is a keyring, yes. Dictionary reading. Pay, noun, that means salary or wages. Pay, when I use it as a verb, that means I give money to somebody. So, as a verb, it has a different meaning. As a noun, it has a different meaning. As a noun, the wages that I get. As a verb, the money that I give it to somebody. Now, opportunities to learn new words surround us. We have to be mindful of that. We have to become conscious of that and we have to keep learning new words at our own pace, reading newspaper and magazines. If we read newspapers and magazines regularly, these newspapers and magazines have areas of interest for everybody. For children, there is children's section. Those who are fond of sports, they can read the sports section. Those who want to read about politics, then there is a lot of news about that. So, those who want to read about what is happening around the world, then also you have a section on that. And accordingly, when you read newspapers and magazines, you will pick up new words. Or some of your passive vocabulary will become part of your active vocabulary. Then reading greeting cards. People give you cards. They wish you good luck, but many a times we don't read the words written inside. It is important to read each and every word. Sometimes some short poems are written inside. So, it's a good idea to read them and appreciate them. Like we read the poem, I wandered lonely as a cloud, and we found out that there are some words which are part of our active vocabulary and there are some words which are part of our passive vocabulary. So, if you read these cards also, which you share with your friends and family, I think it will help you develop your vocabulary. Going to the market, you talk about different products, you learn about different products, so you read the literature of those new items and develop your vocabulary. Using dictionary, that I have been telling since this lesson began. Taking dictation. Yes, taking dictation is a very useful thing in the classroom. You can give dictation to the students, or if you need to improve your vocabulary, you can take dictation, and that too dictation should be in context. So, that will help you know new words and also know the spellings. Solving crossword puzzles, playing word games, reading story books, because reading will help you develop your language, and vocabulary is part of your language. watching TV shows and movies. If you want to develop your English language vocabulary, I think you should be watching English news, English programs, etc. So there are a lot of opportunities around us to learn new words and therefore learn the language. We have come to the end of this session. Thank you for being with us. Good luck. See you, meet you next time with the new topic.